In this podcast, we will present an overview of the new features of EDIUS 9.20. New video scopes for HDR, new color spaces, new color management, monitor control, workgroup version only, floating license model, HDR support in Mync, as well as further improvements in EDIUS. Let's get into the details of these new features. New video scopes for HDR. With the latest updates, EDIUS has been given more and more options for professional color grading, new color spaces, and HDR processing. The previous waveform monitor and the vectorscope have not been adapted to these innovations. In addition, the demand for additional features such as RGB parade and histogram has increased. In EDIUS 9.20, the video scopes are now extended and redesigned accordingly. They can now be scaled and adjusted in more detail. They support not only Rec.709, but also new color spaces and offer the nits display, which is important for HDR. The video scopes appear when clicking on the corresponding icon. Here you can choose between different analysis tools. Use the buttons on the top right to select the desired view. You can adjust the intensity of the display using the corresponding controller. For waveform monitor and vectorscope, you can choose a color or monochrome display. With the scale controller, you can set the opacity of the scales. When the display is enabled, the image information will be displayed on the left when you move the mouse over the image. This feature is very helpful for an accurate color determination. New and essential for the HDR editing is the brightness display in nits. The waveform monitor is a tool for analyzing how the brightness is spread across the image. The image is scanned from left to right. The brightness, also called the luminance, is mapped with its color information in the diagram at the corresponding position. This will reveal which areas need to be corrected. The 100% line corresponds to the brightest, the 0% line to the darkest standard value of the color space used. For optimal exposure, the black levels should not fall below 0%, and the white values should not exceed 100%. As of EDIUS version 9.20, the display is also possible in the YCBCR and RGB modes. A waveform monitor in RGB mode is also called an RGB parade. In this special form of waveform monitor, the values are divided into three RGB channels. The RGB parade is a great way to color analyze the image and correct color casts. For this, the color components of red, green, and blue should be at the same level. The vectorscope is specifically designed to display the color information. The letters RGB stand for the primary colors red, green, and blue. MG, CY, YL stand for the secondary colors magenta, cyan, and yellow. When applying a color bar, the vectorscope displays these colors as measuring points. This is used, for example, when calibrating analog video material. The degree determines the color tone. The more saturated the color is, the farther out it appears in the chromatic circle. Color casts can be recognized by the fact that the dots are not centered in the circle. The new vectorscope is scalable like the other video scopes, but it also offers zoom levels of 75, 100 and 200%. A further added feature is the histogram. Especially former Vegas users have asked for a histogram in EDIUS. It is a so-called RGB histogram, which is divided into the colors red, green, and blue. It represents the color component of the corresponding RGB channel for specific brightness values. As with the waveform monitor, the value 0 corresponds to black and the value 100 to white. By separating into the red, green, and blue parts, the control and adjustment of each color channel is easier. Such a correction works perfectly with the RGB curves of the primary color correction. Unlike the other video scopes, it is possible to set gain in the histogram rather than intensity in order to obtain an optimal representation of the histogram. New color spaces, new color management. EDIUS 9.20 now also supports the color spaces Arri Alexa Wide Gamut / Log C and DJI D-Gamut / D-Log. This will make the list of supported color spaces even larger. In order to keep track of the high number of color spaces, EDIUS version 9.20 introduces a management system for the color space templates. Usually, you do not need to access all color space templates. For example, if you record with a Sony camcorder in Rec.709, S-Log2, S-Log3, and HDR-HLG, you can easily deselect the color space templates you do not need. This will make selecting the color spaces much easier. The information bar can be edited. In addition, the templates can be duplicated, renamed, and the order can be changed. Individually customized template lists can now also be exported and imported onto other EDIUS systems. The adaptation is applied to the primary color correction and clip properties. As well as to the bin window. Monitor control. Workgroup version. For a perfect color display, EDIUS Workgroup version 9.20 now enables the synchronization of the color spaces of the EDIUS project with the monitor. In order to do so, connect the monitor additionally via a USB cable. Currently, the ISO models CG3145, CG318 4K, and CG248 4K are supported. Floating license model. Broadcasters, media companies, and educational institutions have more and more frequently asked for a floating license version of EDIUS. This license model was announced for version 9. In version 9.20, this license model is now introduced. The floating license is not bound to specific computers. The licensing model allows the installation of EDIUS 9 on an unlimited number of workstations within the facility. In the network of the facility, the floating license server software manages the licenses. The licensee pays only for the desired maximum number of concurrent users. This is therefore a purchase model and not a prescription model. The floating license model is available starting with 5 EDIUS Pro 9 or Workgroup 9 licenses. For educational institutions, as with the regular EDIUS version, reduced rates are offered. HDR support in Mync. There is now an HDR workflow available in the media management software Mync. The preview, the storyboard editing, as well as the export, are now all supported in HDR. In addition, on the 6th, 7th or 8th generation of the Intel QuickSync systems, the export in H.265 is now also possible. Further improvements in EDIUS. In the past, there were occasional problems in the EDIUS timeline when saving the track height or the color of the render bars. These problems have now been fixed in the new version. Customers who still have a Matrox MX-02 editing solution can now use it on a Windows 7 or 8 system together with EDIUS. EDIUS 9.20 supports the import of Apple ProRes MXF and Sony Venice RAW. In addition, the processing of Canon Cinema Raw Light material of the Canon C200 has been significantly accelerated. Click here for the next podcast. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. Visit EDIUS.net for more information about EDIUS, plugins, tutorials, and the latest downloads.